Gato Catch. So basically, this is gonna be the same sides, Gato Catch and as well with the Khalid. So most likely gonna be mistaken. That was Lusty. Probably will be the one to use the Hilda. And now, if I'll be predicting on this one, I think Rennie Sports will be a more easier team composition to execute compared into Onyx PH. So, nabago yung setup. Though,
yeah,
there is something on Onyx PH na you have to look forward to because they do have the YSS. Of course, the Mountain Shocker will always be their vision in terms of
Kacha is actually very effective. Once nag-traceless yung YSS palapit, no? Pwede mo lang, pwede ka lang mang-taunt eh. Mm-hmm. Against that, ano eh, that Yisun Shin. And I think malaki namang pang-disable sa Bren, yung mga nawalang pick sa kanila kanina, in the form of the Parsa, I feel like mas madali i-full up pa rin si Yuzong kumpara kay Hilda, di ba?
Totoo.
So, feeling ko mas okay-okay na ngayon ang hulma ng Onyx PH. Okay.
Alright.
So, we are now officially into the game, guys. Napakabilis. It's actually, Dilar, kaagad. Kuha kaagad yung first blood dito. Are they going for it? Di ko na-miss out ko yata. It was on the orange map, probably. But, what I want to emphasize now is, si Iacno palang hawak si Uranus ngayon, no?
Mm-hmm.
Totoo. Totoo yan. Pero, mas maganda. Mas maganda. Nagiging ikot ng Onyx ngayon compared to game number one. And but, Dilar might actually die here, ladies and gentlemen. And, but, na-reset naman dito yung orange map ng
May delay. May delay. Mm-hmm. I think that's quite rewarding. And actually, di pa tapos ha. Jay will jump. Tries to go in. Kinalmot lamang ni Lusty dito. So, everyone is still very much willing to take early gambles in this game, no?
Mm-hmm. Gusto ko yung ano ha, yung pagiging aggressive dito ng Onyx PH. Kasi kanina, parang they're just waiting. Parang a very good opening. Mm-hmm. Pero eto ngayon, they are the one who's being aggressive. Pero yun, the arrow will connect on Oh My Venus.
Napakabilis. Even Lusty went for the flicker just so to get na kilang to Oh My Venus. But few messes up his dive. There is the trap though. At may naisama naman sa langit dito si Paring Pew. Balangin Lights. Speaking of langit, may nanggagaling na spell sa langit. Mountain Shocker stops Bren Esports in responding to back up on Pew. Grabe tol. Willing ka agad lumaban talaga. Parang hindi na talo sa game 1 yung Onyx PH dito.
Oh, mas uminit dito ha, yung laro ng Onyx PH. This is actually the Onyx PH that we're used to see. Na early game pa lang, early stages of the game pa lang, ramdam mo na kagad yung presence.
Yeah. Pero ang threatening din niya, no? Ni Pew. Even for the backline. Tapos Lusty is very much willing to follow up on that, no? Even willing to burn the flicker. And Oh My Venus needs to be careful kasi ayan oh, ang bilis ng follow up ng Brendon. Walang Mountain Shocker eh for that part para talaga mapigilan. And alam mo yun, mapamali ka ng habol, lilingon na kaagad ng Brend. But the problem here is mag-clean up na rin. Mga member dito ng Onyx PH, Cyclone Eye, pinikap ka agad dito ni Flavsy para maiwasan pumatay. Pero speaking of patay, merong masyadong malalim.
Oh grabe. Ladies and gentlemen, pero 1v1 here on the top lane, yung Khalid, kaya niyang isustain talaga yung Tamus. So ito, medyo back and forth yung laban natin ngayon, parang Shane, and I guess it's all about kung paano nila mapipick off dito. If for Brent, they have to find a way na mapick off dito. Yeah.
Okay lang. Now we are back officially. Few pa rin men, the arrows keeps on hitting. Actually, very high pressure, pero mukhang hindi na ganun kalinis yung follow-up ngayon na ginagagawa kay Pew. This is a very heated fight, tol. Like, early to mid na naman yata yung comps o minamata nila, no? Like, you know, ditch the scaling, man. Take the fights that you can. Even Flapsy are getting punished so early. And it does look like Onyx PH is giving Bren a taste of their own medicine that they did kaninang game 1.
Grabe yung aggression na pinapakita rito, ladies and gentlemen, ng Onyx PH. They're really trying to improve every single buff ng Bren.
Oh. Grabe yung away as they don't stop there. That's grabe yung dispersion coming in from Oh My BC. Para nga lang dito na binabato din ni Baring J. And that's it. Dilar will be tagged. Coming in from the Avisa Laron. If you dito, went for the bite. That's the Soul Eater completing the kill. And there goes Oh My Bino from the kalmot na ginawa ng Roger dito. Pero gumanti pa rin naman si Oh My Bino dito after the dispersion. Gets the kill onto the Roger. As J here will be killed as well by few dating teammates. Pero that's it. Ang overall trade 4-for-2 exchange. Mukhang nakalimutan huminga doon ng Onyx PH because Bren was able to answer back very quick. Look at the gold lead here. 500. Oh. Napaka-equal.
Oo, dikit na dikit talaga parang siya. And ang medyo nag-overstay na rin siguro talaga doon yung Onyx doon sa pag-i-invade nila.
Yeah. Was very surprised, no? Ganong kawiling itong dalawa. Considering the composition has a Uranus. Mm-hmm. Wherein your side lane would have been a very strong lane sana, no?
Mm-hmm. Mas ramdam mo nga yung presence ng Uranus. Some other Uranus players will actually gonna be staying on their lane and try to take those turrets. Pero itong Uranus natin dito talaga was actually joining team fights.
Yeah. They're totally joining team fights. And do you think Rob, they need to switch their playstyle here instead of being too aggressive?
I guess they have to keep up the pace.
Yeah. Nako, grabe yan. Ayun yung reaction. Napakalinis ng pull up dito ni Oh My Venus. Pero yung engage talaga ng Brent. Pag nakakuha sila ng momentum, they will continue the push. But Dilar was wise now. He went for the side lane na. Tama na yung pakikipag-away ng maaga against Brent.
May point sa akin, Shane, this is very nostalgic on the different seasons ng MPL. Mm. Kung mapapansin mo dito, Bren Esports, it's hindi nila masyadong pinofocus si Wise. They're really going against Oh My Venus.
Yeah, yes.
Now, which is isa sa naging part of the Family of Sticky that was MPL Season 4, na the Estes run, na pagka pinapasok na namin, they canceled the SS that time, then they go against Oh My Venus. Kumbaga, si Oh My Venus yung hinuhuli lang nila dito and the rest will actually fall apart.
Yeah, I kind of feel na parang Oh My Venus is being too aggressive compared to the capacities of his hero. No? Again, Oh My Venus is already running in 4 deaths here. Ah. But although this is a very bloody fight at na-exchange naman yun ng Onyx DH, still, parang compared to other supports eh, makikita mo ibang i-approach dito ni Imba DJ. Mas controlled si Imba DJ eh. Mm-hmm. Pero hindi mo rin masabing hindi aggressive si Imba DJ dito. Speaking of Jay, we got Jay here getting clapped on by Lusty. Hindi pa naman matutuloy yan. But right now, I thought but feel na nakaka-establish na naman ulit ng ano, no? Map control dito yung Bren, no? Mm-hmm. Rob?
Oo. Actually, ano eh, it was in the first 3 minutes, it was about Onyx PH getting run, having Bren Esports being run down by Onyx. Pero ngayon, nabaliktad siya because of the overstaying doon sa may orange buff ng Bren Esports. Yeah. So ngayon, medyo na nararamdaman na nila yung aggressiveness na ginagawa ng Bren. Look at that. Even Carl TC taking down the YSS just under the tier 2 turret.
That's very dangerous kasi ano yan eh, bounty, no? Mm-hmm. And that's the main core getting removed. Tapos on the side lane, so Bren Esports is also getting turrets for themselves. And there is no answer mula dito sa Onyx PH. The fight carries on. Tuloy-tuloy lang. Jay here, I cannot think they're taking separate fights here. Dali si Oh My Venus, inispatan ka agad ni Ribo talaga. Napakabilis. They will commit for the taunt? No, not anymore. No, Avatar of Guardian gets bumped for that. Pero ayun na yon mga kaibigan. Right now, eto na ulit na naman siguro yung pivot point natin of Bren taking control.
Oo. Medyo, eto, to be honest, na medyo mahihirapan dito na maka-comeback yung Onyx PH in terms of map control. Kasi mas, in terms of mobility, mas mabilis yung Bren Esports. And the only thing that they could be able to pull off is probably Jay could get a good way of Dragon. For example, like Carl TC. I guess Carl TC and Pew are the only ones that could be able to kill as fast. I mean, burst it down as fast as it can.
Yeah. And, kung sakali man, no, para sa iyo, Rob, what do you think? You mentioned yung sakambak in terms of map control. But you think, no, there's the capacity pa rin if you are accounting for the YSS, no?
Mm-hmm.
What about scaling? What are your thoughts on the scaling?
Scaling, I would definitely go for Bren Esports on this one because even the Hilda could be able to deal so much damage, even Rebo, na pwedeng mag all the way mage item. Just to look at how tanky Lusty is.
Yeah, that's massive mga kaibigan. At nahuli na rin yung mission chain, so maybe forget about scaling kung yung carry nyo naman nawawala lang rin. Rebo sa may pinaharapan, and it's gonna be the post na ginawa dyan. Dito sa may daan ni Jay, iyak, no body blocking that. Pero ang kulang ng damage, tol. Mm-hmm. Kulang ng damage. Kanina pa si Rebo nakatambay dyan. Si Flapsing hindi maaray. Blast Iron Fist. Abyssal Trap to the Abyssal Arrow. Re-engage na ginawa dito ni Lusty. And here comes Carl Z. Sumigaw na, pero hindi nung nasumali sa laban. Wala na rin sa rin. He just went for the push on this mid lane inhibitor turret.
Exactly. Actually, tamang-tama doon parang siya na talagang bitin sa damage because nung nawala si Wise, the only damage that they could be able to pull off is coming from Oh My Venus. Pero as a low yi player, ang hirap i-pull off dung duality passive mo kung walang humaharap. Though, Jay could be able to tank, pero not as much as yung usual tankers natin if they have like the Atlas, yung mga ganong klase ng hero. And Iyakno is like almost the same as what the Basha is giving them during the game number one.
Yeah, for this case, no? Pero at least may magandang regeneration pa rin yung Atlas eh. Yung uptime niya laging nandyan. Whenever you get skill, you can easily translate na to an objective. Even some little pressure, minion wave, dahil Atlas regeneration yan. Pero in team fights eh, parang alam mo yun, lamang sa damage ngayon ng Bren. even with Wise on, I can have a feel, no? Kasi may tumatamang araw pa rin eh, pero ayun lang. Ang bilis nun, ha?
It's something that they have to take it. Diba, I mean, sobrang laki ng pag-kill nila doon kay Flat Easy, and this is gonna be a good chance for them to take this level 1 Lord.
Yeah, okay, maganda to. The Lord secured by the members of Team Onyx PH, pero up to what cost? Maybe everything? Na maalam yung Roger lang din. Wala nang mga carries dito because the Yi Sun Shin will also bid goodbye. Tapos kita mo si Jay dito, patay, down the Abyssal Arrow na si Noel Eater ni Pew dito. Napakainit talaga ng silina ni Pew. Pero naging gate na lang doon. Pasok si Iaknu. 2-man, 4, focus dyan. At of course, lalayo na lamang si Dilar. I think wala naman ang objective. Actually, inang-pressure na lang si Iaknu, pero sabi niya na alis na kayo, alis na kayo.
Mm-hmm. Nang just zone out na lang dito, ano? Pero ta, Black TCO sa Edwin here. Kaya-kaya nila to?
Tapang niiyak mo eh. Well, ano eh, alam mo eh, calculated to eh parang.
Totoo. I was even thinking kung kaya ba, even with Flat PC, well-itemed siya dito, like a Sea Halberd, kaya-kaya nilang i-burst down ang isang Uranus.
Bayad na si Iyak, no? Ang may damage na lang tol dyan, ano, Roger, no? Oh my god, that is gonna be a big ray of hope for the members dito ng Onyx PH, pero ginawa ni Dilar. Nakalimutan niya yata ang siyak na yung mahunat.
Mga kaibigan,
I think hindi naman kailangan sana mapatay ng ganun basta-basta si Dilar, no?
Mm-hmm.
Well, they're just gonna go here for the mid lane side. You get the Lord pushing on that inhibitor turret, but it's quite expected naman para makakuha ng push. Tolawa ng bawi, no? Ang inakala nating scaling ni Yu Sin Shin kay Iaknu na punta, no?
Mm-hmm. Kumbaga, si Iaknu, ang maganda rito for the side of Onyx PH is wala pa ni isa from Brent Esports could be able to bring him down. Siguro, they could be able to burst it once tamaan siguro ng pana and a good chunk of damage na magagaling kay Flap Easy. Yeah. Aside from that, kayang i-regen lahat ng damage na binabatuloy.
Yeah. Kung di mo matuluyan eh, no? Kung di mo matuluyan. Tsaka, ito lang din, maybe they can capitalize kapag masyadong malalim si Iaknu. Tapos hindi maka-follow up yung teammates ng Onyx. Importante pa rin, I think Iaknu should be mindful na hindi lang siya pwede basta-basta pumasok. Kailangan na pa-follow upan rin. So, may sense yung pasok niya pa rin, no?
Oo. Grabe, no? Yung talagang, ito yung masasabi mo, the tables have turned dito sa laban na to.
Flips table, eh, no? Well, now, kanina ina-count natin yung comeback dito ng Onyx PH. And does look like the comeback is already established. Any thoughts on the comeback possibility ng Brent?
Possibly, they have to itemize at least dito para kay Iaknu. Kasi yung over,
yun lang. Carry pa naman, binulls ay doon mula sa Avatar of Guardian na maalam yung issue siya na pit-pit eh. Binagsakan ba? Binagsakan ka. Ang isang malutong nagatot kacha. Pero eto, kunat ang meron sila. Hindi damage. Kita mo, umaray kami from the AOE. On the melee from the Hilda. Buti na lang natuluyan yung Hilda. Naka-re-engage pa si Dilar because naka-on na yung kanyang counter on Inferno. Habol pa dito. May belat pang ginawa si Iaknu in this game. Number 2 might be it. Might be put into the pocket of the members of Onyx PH na nagigigil. Makabawi.
Beno, ito yung naging parang saving grace nila dito, the Uranus, since the damage na magagaling dito for the Brent Esports is mostly melee, and mas kaya mas lalo na nakakapag-heal dito ang isang